Good day, Table Rush Talk Show listeners. I am so glad to have you on and listening and watching today. Just wanted to start with that. But anyway, this episode is all about how to borrow somebody's authority. How to borrow somebody's authority. I had a major breakthrough, epiphany moment, aha moment. I finally sort of saw how to borrow somebody's authority and the power of it. So listen in and learn. All right, as everybody knows by now, or perhaps you don't because you're new to the show. Welcome, new to the show people. Somebody just walked by. If you've listened to any of my previous episodes, I just think it's so funny. I am the crazy person. You realize as we walk and talk and record into these boxes, it's a fine line between the homeless and us. I'm just saying, homeless people are walking around rambling. They're rambling away. Who are they talking to? They probably have an audience. We just can't see it. Anyhow, I've been diligently publishing every day for a year, actually more than a year now, and it took me about a year and 1 month to have some major breakthroughs, epiphanies. Well, about the power of doing that, which maybe I'll get to in this episode, maybe I won't. Just know that publishing every day for a year to your chosen platform and what I would consider a publishable platform, because it's indexable, it's SEO searchable, it has longevity as a base of content that you own. I would consider that YouTube channel, because you're creating the video. Searchable, obviously, YouTube, highly searchable, indexable. Somebody searches something, there's a great chance your documentation, your story, your whatever comes up. Well, it can. You know what I mean? There's not a great chance. There is a chance. Or podcasts. Podcasting is super searchable, indexable. Somebody could go to google.com and search the subject that you talk about, and then all of a sudden your podcast comes up because you've got show notes, because you've got, you know, the terms at the right places. And it can be super messy. Trust me, my podcast is coming up in certain places now because it's out there and findable. And then lastly, blogging, and it's definitely come into my awareness how powerful blogging is. You know, the written story. What I don't consider publishing, although a ton of people would argue, would be posting on Facebook, would be posting on Instagram, would be posting on TikTok, Snapchat, any of that stuff. This is what I would tell you. Those are distribution channels. How about think of it that way? That's just a distribution channel. Facebook could go out of style today, overnight. There's Facebook slaps, Google slaps, there's all these terms. And if that's your main source, that's no good. However, if you control the content, if you control the creation and blog, podcast, YouTube channel, you can slice and dice, repurpose all that content out to the social media channels. So those are distribution channels. And there's going to be new distribution channels. There's Clubhouse, there's all these things out there. I'm an old guy, so, well, oldish. There's people older than me. But as I'm in my 50s, perhaps I'm not as aware of the new apps as they come into fruition. What's another distribution channel? LinkedIn, Twitter. So create your content on your blog, your YouTube channel. And again, YouTube channel could go away, but if you're in the, you have all that video searchable stuff, right? Because you're in effect creating it and then pushing it out on YouTube. You get what I'm saying. People are going to disagree. A ton of people are having success just TikToking, are building businesses straight from TikTok. God bless them. Go do that if that's calling to you. Now, thank you for listening to that rant. The power of authority. So I've interviewed a bunch of people. I recently had interviewed somebody, a memory specialist, Lisa Randall. She's a genius. Check it out. You can hear it. You can watch the Lisa Randall interview on the YouTube channel, or you can listen to it on the Table Rush talk show, which also goes out as a podcast. Just Google Table Rush talk show on any of the, or search Table Rush talk show on any of the major podcasting platforms, and it'll come up. But again, the power of borrowing somebody's authority. So Lisa Randall, super smart memory specialist, she literally helps people thrive in old age with her memory courses. Like, she helps them have better memories in old age than they did before they hit old age. She proves through science, science proves that the illusion of your memory having to go, of Alzheimer's, of all these things, perhaps is just that, an illusion, if you work on it. Not to say that, whatever, those are rabbit holes I don't need to go down. You get what I'm saying. Lisa's super smart. I interviewed her, had a lot of fun, had to switch hands on the water bottle. I sliced and diced that content. I sliced and diced that into a bunch of 15, 30 second, 1 minute clips, probably about 10 of them, 15 of them. I'm currently in this repurpose content mode. And, so I push it all out across, I push it all out across the distribution channels, across YouTube Shorts, across Reels, across, you know, Instagram and Facebook Reels, across TikTok, just those. Created a ton of engagement. It was super awesome. And I posted engaging clips of her being really smart and explaining how it all works. The hypothalamus, all these things. Go listen to the interview. You'll figure out what the hypothalamus is. I started getting direct messages asking me about memory stuff, right? They're like, oh my gosh, you're so smart about all this stuff. Oh my gosh, you know, this is the course that I like. Oh my gosh, you should read this book. Oh my gosh, tell me more. Misha, tell me more. How'd you get involved in all this memory stuff? I interviewed somebody. Slice and dice the interview, chopped it up, send it out. It's very powerful. All of a sudden, I'm perceived as an expert in the memory space. And all I did was interview somebody, ask some engaging questions, smile. I'm very, I react a lot. Like, I'm very emotive. So I have that going for me. Or not. If you like unemotive people, then you will be irritated by the way I respond to people. But no matter, I got to borrow Lisa's authority. I'm very excited to interview, because I'm all into sales and marketing. Like, that's my main thing that I'm talking about and diving into right now. I love spirituality, love A Course in Miracles, I love prayer, meditation. You know, I'm all into the 12-step recovery programs, just been sober a super long time. Lots of stuff I'm into. But I'm excited to... I've interviewed some really smart sales and marketing people, and I can't wait to slice and dice that content, push it out, and I am an authority. I've sold a lot of stuff, done a lot of marketing, but in the digital area. Anyway, you get what I'm saying. I'm very excited to create that engagement to increase my authority by interviewing other people, and then repurposing that content and distributing it out across the channels. All right, I'm done. That might be my most concise episode in in 8 or 10. Thank you for joining me on the journey. Love to all. Subscribe in the bottom corner. I think it is right over there. If you're listening on a podcast platform, subscribe, rate, give me a 5-star. If you're watching this on YouTube, is it subscribe or follow? I don't know. I'm still sorting all that out. Love to all. La 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 la